Mississippi in this stadium under the lights, the most unique setting in the SEC. Welcome to SEC Saturday Night.
Wait.
Welcome to SEC Saturday Night, presented by T-Mobile. Cowbells are ringing, and we are ready to rock at Davis Way Stadium, where Mississippi State has had a nice little run against Kentucky lately. The 12th-ranked Cats show up, looking for their first win at Stark Vegas since Randall Cobb was their quarterback. Mississippi State behind the door and led by the most prolific passer in all of college football, Will Rogers. Here come the Bulldogs, and it's game night in Starkville. That guy loves his mom. He forgot his shirt, but he brought his cowbell. And he is ready to rock, just like this Mississippi State team looking for a big win. Cats have plenty of big wins under Mark Stoops. On their way, perhaps, to a historic season in the Bluegrass. And they hit the field amidst a chorus of boos. It's like these teams are rivals or something. Welcome, everybody. Glad to be here with you and have you with us. Tom Hart, Jordan Rogers, Cole Kublik down on the field. The season for Kentucky can't be understated. Yeah, coming off a loss to the number one team in the country in Georgia. But this could be, at the end, the best season in Kentucky history. They have a chance to play in the Sugar Bowl, or if chaos continues in college football, maybe even something better.
Yeah, but to take that step from good to great, it's games like these that the consistency has to stay where it is. They had a tough one against Georgia. They have to rise to the occasion tonight. They've done it pretty untraditionally. There's no five stars, no superstars on this roster. They play good defense. They run the football. But the one superstar, the most dangerous guy on the field is Wandale Robinson. And if Kentucky is going to hit big plays, if they're going to be explosive on offense, it's all going to run through number one. And because he is the guy, they got to move him all over the place, Tom, to get him the football. You're going to see him line up on the right side, on the left side, go in motion. All these lines right here are times that against Georgia, he either was targeted or he went in motion. It totaled 28 times. That accounted for 40% of all the plays Kentucky ran. So for Mississippi State tonight, identifying where Wandale Robinson is on the field is going to be paramount before every snap, because this offense runs through number one.
Kentucky native transferred in from Nebraska, and he has been an impact player for Mark Stoops, kind of guy he was looking for offensively. Mississippi State might be a little light defensively as they try to figure out how to defend Wandale Robinson, Will Levis, and the rest of his crew. For more on that, here's Cole.
Well, it's going to be tough sledding in the secondary when you're trying to take care of number one for Kentucky. Fred Peters, safety, is going to be out for Zach Arnett's defense tonight. Second leading tackler on the team, Tom. So, this Mississippi State secondary known to screen down, play against the run, obviously understand how to play the pass as well. But that's a big loss from a communication standpoint as well to the Mississippi State Bulldogs.
Well, Mississippi State has an offensive attack under Mike Leach. It is second to none when it comes to passing. Pass first, pass middle, pass last, pass often. And they got a quarterback that has now grown into this role. Remember last year against Kentucky, when they didn't score a single point on offense, Rogers was just getting into his role as Mississippi State's quarterback.
Yeah, he's grown a ton since last year, especially since that Kentucky game where we saw this offense so flat. After that is when Will Rogers really took over. And he's grown a ton in understanding this offense, being comfortable in it, using his eyes. He is dangerous. But at the end of the day, it's still a scheme that Kentucky knows what's going to happen on every play. So how does Mississippi State adapt if they do tonight?
Mark Stoops adapted. He was tired of losing here in Starkville. The home team has won six straight in a series that began in 1914, and State has won 9-12. Stoops said, put us in a different hotel. Let's stay closer than having to get on a bus every time. Get on a bus, have to drive all the way to the stadium. They're staying in the closest hotel to the stadium. A pitching wedge away.
That's why we had to stay in an Airbnb. Huh? They took all the rooms right here.
That's right. State's got the party down. Kentucky's used to the pre-kick dancing. What a scene in Starkville. State won the toss and elected to defer, so Kentucky will get the football first. SEC Saturday night, presented by T-Mobile. Kind of forgot how loud it can get in this building.
Tell you what, those cowbells, here they come. That's a sound like no other in college football.
Chance for a return from the four-yard line. Out to the 20 goes Zach Johnson. Penn State transfer Will Levis, a junior from Madison, Connecticut. Last two games has been sensational. 78% completion, 5 touchdowns, no picks. He's actually been better against pressure than when he's not pressured. A week off to prepare for Mississippi State's unique defense. Tavashe Smoke will be the starting tailback. Screen for Robinson, and they trip him up after he gets 4. Kentucky happy to welcome Josh Ali back to the fold tonight. What difference does he make?
It's a huge addition. He is a legitimate number 2 receiver in this league, so his ability to stretch the field and also take a little bit of the attention off Wandale Robinson so the defense can't key on number 1 every single play. Going to see Josh Ali here at the top of your screen. They're going to take a few shots to him tonight.
A motion Justin Rigg that direction. On 2nd and 6, Smoke runs in to a defender, can only find 2. Jalen Green came up from his safety spot. Third down and loud. Brings 3. Levis running out of time. Going to try to run for it. And he dives to pick up the yardage. A fresh set of downs for the Cats.
And this is something Kentucky is going to have to evaluate early. How and when Mississippi State's going to bring pressure. They stack the line of scrimmage that time, drop everybody out. And this is what makes Will Levis so dangerous. He's a big body, extremely athletic. When it's not there, he'll tuck it and run.
The toss for Smoke. Bookie watching with the tackle. Kentucky's got a first-year offensive coordinator, and Liam Cohen came from the NFL's Rams, part of a great coaching tree with Sean McVay. Last 2 years spent with the Rams. They are 7th in the conference in rushing, 2nd to last in passing, 11th total. A lot of those impacted by the numbers last week against Georgia.
Two tight ends in the game here for Kentucky.
Four-man rush this time. A bullet to one of those tight ends, and it's Rigg who hauls it in. Gain of 4.
One little wrinkle you're seeing from Kentucky here early. The inline tight end, so the tight end with their hand on the ground, a little extra split between he and the offensive tackle, probably trying to open up that C gap for some runs later in this game.
That second tight end was Brendan Bates. He goes back to the sideline for his 3rd and 4. I'll ask you about the check with me if Kentucky gets his first down. Levis looking to the sideline. Reevaluating the defense. Pressure up the middle. Blitz picked up. Levis trying to escape. And he dumps it to Robinson, who got cleaned at the 40. Flags come flying. It was Martin Emerson with State already a man short in the secondary.
personal foul.
Targeting on the defense number one. That play is under review.
We'll take a look at this one upstairs. Lee Hendrick and his crew had it as targeting. Here's your look.
Yeah, so here's what you evaluate first. Is he a defenseless player? Yes. Right? He's a receiver catching the ball, doesn't have enough time to turn and make a football move. And then you need to see, is there forcible contact and an indicator? I think everything right there checks the box.
Crown of the helmet, yep. Defenseless player.
Yeah, see the crown of the helmet duck there on a defenseless player.
Boy, what a hit this would be for Mississippi State to lose Martin Emerson with Fred Peters already out from one of the safety spots. Now to go down a corner.
And I was down on the field talking to Liam Cohen earlier before the game, and he mentioned Emerson. He mentioned Forms. These are two guys that are really good cover guys on the back end. He said we're going to have to move around, try to avoid these guys as much as possible. So would be a huge loss for Mississippi State. And the way I see it, that looks like textbook targeting.
After review, the ruling on the field of targeting is confirmed using the crown of the helmet by the defense number one. Number one of the defense has been disqualified for this game.
What a huge loss for Mississippi State. It comes 3.5 minutes into this game. And now, as we discuss everything that Kentucky does with Wandale Robinson, Nevison, you have one last guy who can match up with Robinson.
Yeah, Richardson will come in as his replacement, but not quite the caliber of Martin Emerson, one of the better cover guys in this league. So let's see if Kentucky starts to test early, right? Explosive plays are something Kentucky hasn't been able to hit. Do they go after 30 early here?
I'd test them with the outside run game first.
Play action. Levis has a huge arm. Trying to fit one in. It is intercepted! Taken away by State. Sean Preston Jr. Preston, starting in lieu of Peters, has his first takeaway of the season.
Play action to the boundary, gets that corner low, and then it's a lot of green grass for Wandale Robinson. This ball has got to be thrown on a line. This one just hung up too long. Will Levis a little too much air there. He's got to rip that one on a line and pull Wandale Robinson more towards the sideline. It's a throw here, one back.
Will Rogers leads the FBS in completions and attempts. We'll see a unique Kentucky defense tonight. They show a three-man front and already 8 in coverage. Quick hitter to find some green grass. That's to Jaden Wally, who picks up 5. What does Brad White want to do defensively tonight against the air raid?
Yeah, he wants his guys to get their cleats in the ground with depth. Now, normally when you hear cleats in the ground, it's a defense adjusting to tempo. For his linebackers, his droppers, he wants them to get to depth really quick and turn and get your eyes on the quarterback, because you're going to have to rally and tackle to those short throws that Mississippi State lives in.
You see 13, J.J. Weaver lined up as a defensive end in his front. He's got more speed on that defensive line than typical. And so State will run it with Jaquavius Marks, and Marks gets stood up. So if Kentucky can stop the run with that front, it's playing right into Brad White's hands.
Absolutely, and you have Justin Rogers in there because Marquand McCall, not healthy still, but Josh Pascal is a heck of a two-way player. He's big enough that he can be stout against the run. He's fast enough and athletic enough to give you some pass rush in that three-man front. That's the make or break when you play Mississippi State. Can you get pressure with 3?
Mike Leach, a play caller, first in the SEC in passing. He does not care to run the football, even though they went to it early. On a 3rd and 2, first down for Mekhi Polk, who's 4th in the country with 8 1/3 catches per game.
And he's special. What a great addition, the Cal transfer. The thing with Polk is, yes, he leads the SEC in receptions, but look at the yards after catch. So low. They got to find ways to get him more options in grass with space. Those quick throws, a lot of times, he's got a guy right over the top of him.
Rodgers fires over the middle. That's good for another Mississippi State first down. Going back to Polk, is that a byproduct of how they're being defended as a team? A lot more zone than man?
Absolutely, but also because he'll play on the outside a lot to the boundary as well, so there's not as much opportunity to cut to the field or get open spaces. You see him here at the top of your screen to the boundary. Maybe move him around a little bit. Find ways to get him the ball in space because he is your best receiver on the outside.
They'll run it again. This is Marks. Two runs in the first possession for Mike Leach. It's a pickup of four that time.
Well, the overhit for that one.
Yeah, it sure did. You're talking about zone or man, drop eight. We saw Barry Odom do it at Arkansas last year against him, and then Brad White did it the next week. Their first game of the season came against Bo Pelini's LSU defense. He stuck in man the entire game, and it was a field day. Crossing routes goes. Everything went. Everybody said, well, that's the fire I don't want to touch.
Yeah, that's what this offense wants. They want you to get man because then they can pick you. They can rub you. They can find ways to create grass. When you sit and drop eight, it really shrinks the field in a weird way for this offense. Makes it tough.
Tucky feigns pressure. Now they bring it from the front side, and they get to him. Will Rogers goes down on a sack from Josiah Hayes. I asked Brad White before the game, how do you know when to bring pressure? He said it's a feel thing.
Yeah, it's the stunt on the inside there by Josh Pascal that takes the guard and the tackle, kind of opens things up for Josiah Hayes to clean that up. But really, the coverage on the back end didn't allow Will Rogers to get rid of that ball when he had to move the pocket.
First sack of the season for the sophomore out of Horn Lake, Mississippi. Kentucky's been really good on third down this season. Games up front again. Quick to the slant and it is bobbled and incomplete. Trying to get it to Marks from the slot. And State's going to have to punt it away.
But how about this? You got a third and one. Here in an empty back set. And Kentucky, it just gave way too much cushion at the line of scrimmage there for Woody Marks. Marks actually third in the SEC in receptions as well. He's a running back, but he might as well be a receiver in this option or in this offense for how much he catches the ball over the middle of the field.
Tucker Day to punt it away. Josh Ali back from injury, set to return. Tucky came after it. Ali will have some space. Trying to find the edge. Outside the hash. Now straight up field. Josh Ali's got a convoy in front. He's got the sideline. He is gone. 73-yard punt return for a score for Josh Ali. Big play on big play. First the State pick, and then Ali takes it to the house.
How happy is Kentucky to have him back in the lineup? They just really were lacking in explosiveness on the outside, not just in the special teams, but on the offensive side as well, with everything running through Wandale Robinson. Welcome back, Josh Ali.
Matt Ruffalo for the point after. And he drills it. State had the early momentum with the pick, and it's Kentucky's special teams that have the Cats rolling early, officially 74 yards. Ali, great vision, and he turned on the afterburners with blockers in front. Kentucky in front early. To have Josh Ali back. First punt return for a score since Lynn Bowden did it against Penn State in the Citrus Bowl 2019 on New Year's Day. Kentucky could be aiming for a better bowl than that, which is really remarkable to say. That was a beloved Kentucky team. Both of these programs vastly improved even over last year, that COVID season, all SEC campaign. This season, All-State will celebrate every field goal and extra point made by participating universities by making a donation to the university's general scholarship fund. Thank you, All-State. Davis Wade Stadium in Starkville. And Will Rogers, who ran the air raid in high school, coming out of Brandon High School in Mississippi. Asked him if he was familiar with the cowboy actor entertainer Will Rogers and his favorite quotes. He said, yeah, never miss a good chance to shut up. And he lets his play do the talking. Here's Malik Heath. Cedric Dort forces him out after a gain of four. What does Mississippi State want to do play by play offensively?
Well, it's really ball control, right? That quick throw to the sideline is their run game. You say, well, they don't run the ball often. Well, that's a run play. You got two blockers at receiver, a quick high percentage throw. See if you can block somebody, make something happen. They just got to generate more explosive plays off those quick throws.
Three-man rush. Out of the backfield, it's Dillon Johnson who made the first man miss. There's another answer, right? Make your own explosive, but make you guys miss.
And that's being patient. I just mentioned explosive plays. Well, when you play in the defense, it's dropping eight. There's not much room down there, so you got to continually take these short throws and then hope that Kentucky starts to get greedy, starts to get their eyes in the backfield, and that's when you can hit them behind the coverage.
Another run. This is Dillon Johnson, who gets tripped up over the logo after a gain of six. Martez thrower in on the tackle. This is a pass-heavy offense. If you didn't know, sounds redundant every time we talk about it. They put it in the air nearly 58 times a game. They run a lot of plays. Pressure coming late. Over the middle. Caught. First down. Plenty more. Jaden Wally gets lit up at the 25, but a flex after a gain of 28.
And this is a great example of Will Rogers taking the next step in this offense. Look at him working to the left. He moves that linebacker. Actually, I think that's Yusuf Corker, the safety. Moves him to the left and hits Wally right over the middle of the field where Corker was.
We have seen some hard hits here early on tonight. Little toss to Dillon Johnson. They go into the net. They're fighting like Cousins and Corbin. Gain of four. Marquez Bembry put him over to the net.
I like the commitment. Well, you say commitment, you use it lightly, of Mike Leach actually running the football.
Yeah.
Getting a lot of two defensive linemen in the game for Kentucky. You have to attack it. Have to try to get Brad White to exchange that personnel so you can continue to have success down the field.
This is the discussion pregame with UK's defensive coordinator. Pressure, and Rogers goes down. Vito Tisdale came flying in like he was shot out of a cannon. Well, cost him 7 yards, second sack for the Cats.
Yeah, and they'll lull you to sleep with this drop eight, and then all of a sudden they'll bring pressure right off the edge. You see Tisdale, number seven, kind of hiding behind the defensive end. And decides to add late. That's the thing. You see so much drop eight, drop eight, drop eight, rush three, and all of a sudden you're looking left, and they bring an extra guy to the right.
Third and 14 to Polk, and it's broken up by Tisdale. Tisdale had to miss a good chunk of the season, chunk of practice, and he's playing like a guy whose clock is ticking. He is a high-energy player, whether it's on special teams or on defense.
And Will Rogers looks a little banged up there as he kind of limps to the sideline.
47-yard attempt for Brandon Ruiz. Long this season is 44. No breeze and a cool night. Temperatures in the low 50s here. And it drifts right. No good. They shot the fireworks off anyway. Kentucky pitching a shout out early. 7-0 Cats on a punt return.
SEC Saturday Night is presented by T-Mobile, the leader in 5G, America's largest, fastest, and most reliable 5G network. and in part by new Coca-Cola Zero Sugar and Wendy's Hot and Crispy Fries. Try the best combo ever today.
Some of the major bowls that Kentucky has played in their program's history, the 1951 Sugar may have a comp to tonight's game. Bear Bryant is trying to slow down number one Oklahoma. They're split T offense, so use a multi-look defense. And sometimes they had nine men on the line. Brad White's going the opposite of that, going as light as possible on the defensive line tonight. A 1951 team would finish the season 11-1 by knocking off Oklahoma in the Sugar. Levis flips it out. Here's Josh Ali again. He joined us late. He had a 74-yard punt return for a touchdown for the game's lone score.
And just the eighth play for Kentucky. So offensive coordinator Liam Cohen is still in his first 15 plays. You're going to see a lot of formation variation, different personnel grouping to see how Mississippi State adjusts early.
There's Kavashe Smoke, carries it for a first down. Pick up a seven.
And really the biggest question mark talking to Liam Cohen down on the field is, he's like, man, there just wasn't hardly any film on 12 personnel for Mississippi State. I have no idea what they're going to do. So we saw it last drive, a little 12 personnel, see how they adjust, how they align. And then you can start to carve your game plan out and see how it's going to end up. Again, 12 personnel, two tight ends in here at the top of your screen.
That's that wide split from the tight end is in line again.
Rigg changes direction. Rodriguez couldn't handle the toss and they'll end up losing a yard and a half. Showed Liam Cohen a moment ago.
Ball security has been a little bit of an issue for Rodriguez. A couple fumbles on the season. That's a good pitch right there. Just took his eyes off it.
Cohen came to Kentucky from the Rams. Rams 6-1 under Sean McVay. They're in Houston tomorrow afternoon. He said it's not uncommon. Sean McVay and his guys will be watching our game on Saturday night, doing their game planning last second. He goes, I don't get to watch theirs till Wednesday. Rodriguez, this one will look good. Then he coughs it up. Johnson falls on it, and they did not spot him down. Jet Johnson has the fumble recovery. It'll be Mississippi State football. They will take a look at this to make sure.
Rolling on the field is a fumble.
Chris Rodriguez Jr. has butterfingers early. You got the elbow down?
Yeah. Both of them. I got that down. You could see right before. Notice how
on the field is the fumble recovered by the defense. That play is under review.
Notice how his other hand was grasping his forearm. I mean, he is very conscious of ball security, as I mentioned. He's put it on the ground a few times this year already. That time, good security. The ball knocked it out.
They will take an extra look at this. Why do that? They do it. We'll pay bills. We'll show you after this. Oh, get the trap up. Here's Chris Rodriguez on a 15-yard gain. And after the officials reviewed this, ruled that he was down, it will stay Kentucky football. Turnovers have been an issue for Kentucky all season long. They're one of eight teams with a minus eight turnover margin, one of seven, pardon me. The other six have a combined record of 14-30. It's just really hard to win if you turn the ball over.
Yeah, it's one of the biggest predictors to win-loss is protecting the football. So Kentucky somehow has overcome that adversity. And once again, dodge a bullet there.
Kavashe Smoke, no game.
He really had been cleaning it up, though. That interception earlier, just the second turnover since September 25th. So obviously a lot of that skewed by the first few weeks of the season. Just can't get back to what you were earlier in the year.
Rodriguez misplayed a toss earlier this drive, was able to fall on it. Now second and 11. Here's Kavashi smoke. He got wrapped up and thrown down by Cameron Young. Cole, what makes this Mississippi State defense so unique under Zach Arnett?
Well, he's a Rolodex play caller, which means you're not really going to be able to determine by down and distance or place on the field or yard line what you think he's going to run, even at a certain formation. So he'll give you certain looks. You have an idea what's going to come, but his Rolodex goes so deep that he can just change it up series by series, game by game.
Played for his coach, Rocky Long, at San Diego State. Played for him at New Mexico, coached with him. And it's at Rocky Long 3-3-5 defense. Play clock is at 6. Levis still checking. Now 2. And they say he got it off. Levis, out route, complete. And they were all over Wandale Robinson, who picked up 7. Forbes with the coverage and the tackle.
Really, really good throw here by Will Levis, because the corner is going to see this one on the outside. Levis puts that ball quickly and accurately on Wandale Robinson.
Injured player for Mississippi State over on that side where the play ended, Emmanuel Forbes, who was converging with Bookie Watson on that coverage. Wandale Robinson, 3 catches for 15 yards. He's been targeted 4 times already tonight.
Now, there's so many ways they can get him the ball, and especially we talked about how much they move him. Well, there's 3 reasons they do that. They move him on these jet sweeps, give him a little ball, maybe hand it off. They move him to create space and create matchups all the time. Get tight, get heavy, put him on the outside, create some green grass, get him the ball in space. And then this is the dangerous one. They use him a lot as a decoy. Saw it against Georgia. We see it in every single game. Get the defense to pay attention to where he is. And then a little sleight of hand, throw it in the opposite direction.
Wandale Robinson and his Kentucky teammates have a 7-0 lead through 1 quarter of play, thanks to a punt return by Josh Ali. Cats continuing this drive. It'll be the 8th as they flip sides as we head to the 2nd.
Studio, let's update what's going on the plains. 10th-ranked Ole Miss already in some trouble. Tank Bixby, 70 rushing yards, not quite through the first quarter. Auburn leads Ole Miss 14-3. We'll keep you posted. It's on ESPN.
Dari, the real news in that game, Matt Corral is exiting the game with an ankle injury. It's the kind that looks very serious if Ole Miss has to try to do without Matt Corral. That is a steep hill to climb.
Yeah, this offense is not the same. It runs through Matt Corral, the best player in the entire country, so would be a massive loss. And already Auburn up 14-3. That one could get interesting.
They got Luke Altmyer in a quarterback now. By the way, Chris Lemonis in the background trying to fire up the crowd. They just honored the College World Series champs. There's Lem and his great crew. Fantastic coaching staff. They hit 6 on the College World Series team as they won the school's first national title. Most outstanding player, Will Bednar. Forbes tried to stick around. He's got an exit for a game, for a play. Logan Tanner, Luke Hancock, Lane Forsythe, Tanner Allen, and Rowdy Jordan, the aptly named Rowdy. Guys that were named on the all-tournament team. That great run in Omaha. And State fans absolutely took over the town. That was really cool to see. Great to have that team honored here tonight. Here's Chris Rodriguez. Bullies his way to a gain of 9.
Kentucky got heavy on that play. Went to 22 personnel, 2 tight ends, 2 backs, 2 pullers got out on the edge and were able to capture the edge. This is where things get interesting towards the red zone. Both these teams extremely efficient. But the chess match all night will be the run game for Kentucky against a really good stout run defense for Mississippi State.
It's about even in terms of plays and time of possession. You wouldn't figure a pass happy offense like State would be right there. And it'll be 3rd and short as smoke got cut down before the line to gain. But Mississippi State 7th in the country, leading the SEC in time of possession. And Kentucky would love to eat up as many minutes as they could. It's kind of it may not be an old school offense for State, but an old school matchup in that regard.
Yeah, it's ball control, right? Although Mississippi State throws the ball so much, a lot of completions, the clock continues to run, and a huge 3rd and short here.
Going big again, Levis will keep it and splash over for the 1st down.
asked Coach Leach about time of possession after the walkthrough yesterday, guys. He kind of said he didn't really care about time of possession. He said, for me, it's about amount of plays. I want to get as many plays in as possible because that gives us more opportunities to create points.
Cole, he cares more about your son's Halloween pirate costume than he does time of possession.
Listen, I've seen Mike Leach light up about a few things, but I had to get the expertise of the actual pirate on my son dressing up as a pirate. It's as happy as I've ever seen him.
Couple of swashbucklers. Smoke will exit the backfield.
And we get man coverage here at the bottom with Wandale Robinson and Josh Ali.
Levis going that way. And Ali broke his route off. Pass wasn't near Robinson. What happened there?
Just a little miscommunication. I think Wandale Robinson maybe has the opportunity here to go either direction. And with no safeties in the middle there, he chose the middle. If there was a one high, he probably should take the outside. Maybe Levis didn't notice the safety rolled out of the middle and a miscommunication.
In that scenario, what role does Ali's route have on Robinson's decision?
Well, that's one that Levis would have to identify. No safeties, we should take the middle. Yep. There is a safety, so I think Wandale was right there, just on a different page.
They've second and 10 now. Levis. A bullet to Robinson. First man can't bring him down. The second can. Gain of one. Colin Duncan there for State.
What a great job by Colin Duncan. In coverage, rallied to the short throw and made a great tackle. Now third and long here for Kentucky. This is where Mississippi State, at times, will roll the dice, bring some pressure, maybe drop back. Let's see.
13th play of the drive for Kentucky.
Mississippi State's going to bring pressure.
Levis feels it, escapes. On the run, incomplete. That was a bullet for Isaiah Epps.
Like I said, Mississippi State will roll the dice. They go zero man coverage on the outside. Actually, one high there. Levis does a great job of buying time. That ball just maybe a foot behind. Doesn't lead Epps. It's a tough throw to make on the run. And a great job by Forbes. Undercut and almost came up with an interception.
And so Kentucky will line it up and try for a Matt Ruffalo 41-yard field goal. In his fifth year as Kentucky Wildcat. And he splits them. Kentucky's got a long field goal and a punt return for a touchdown. It's a 10-0 UK lead on the road in Starkville.
Great guest list for the Mannings tonight.
You've reached Peyton and Eli. Leave a message.
Hey guys, it's Bill. I'd love to come on and inject some energy into the Megacast. Call me back. Watch Peyton and Eli. You never know who'll drop by.
Not a great night for Eli. They just saw the Ole Miss quarterback, Matt Corral, being carted off back in the locker room. What is a Heisman-like campaign for Matt Corral? Certainly dealing with a roadblock, at least for tonight, with Auburn leading 14-3. Tula Griffin back to receive this one for State. Chance Poor with a line drive. What's key for Mississippi State in the air raid?
Well, when you play drop eight, everything plays deep. So you got to find ways to generate explosive plays off these short throws. And it comes down to receivers blocking. Last week, they did a great job of this. These receivers probably do a lot of O-line drills because they have to. They're out in space. This is an extension of the run play. It's also a way they generate those explosives. Tom, longest play of the year for Mississippi State offense, 43 yards.
Wow.
Receivers do what drills?
Maybe they do a little O-line blocking. I don't know. I mean, come on.
Rodgers.
I like it's that hard, Cole.
6 of 8 tonight. He went 41 of 57 for 384 and 4 touchdowns against Vandy. Kentucky drops 8. Rodgers goes out of the backfield to Marks. What did you see with old Rodgers, Cole?
He got some medical attention, actually, when he came off after the previous drive. But it didn't look like they were paying attention to anything specific. Maybe a cramp. Looked like he was a little bit tight. Went and got over on the bike for a few seconds, just trying to loosen himself up.
It's like taking your car in before vacation. Just, hey, just look at everything here, okay? Check the belts, tire pressure, oil, anything. Marks gets hit as he spun around, picked up the first down on a gain of 7.
You know, early in this game, Kentucky was very light up front. Fitzgerald back in the game, so they have two true D tackles back in the game. First couple drives, just one D lineman and a couple linebackers. Yep. Mississippi State was able to break a couple runs. Looks like they're getting heavier on the front now.
A.J. Weaver in there for a face mask on Justin Rogers, one of those defensive linemen you're talking about. That'll take State into Kentucky territory. Again, Marks. And Marks puts a move on. Wow. Went right by the freshman Trevin Wallace for 14.
That used to be as a defense when they check the ball down, that's a win. But anytime you check the ball down to Marks, he's liable to make a big play. Rarely does that first guy get him.
So talking with Brad White before the game, I said, if you guys go light up front, do you expect Mike Leach will eventually run? And he just kind of laughed. He said, no. The guy may have tendencies, but that's one thing he doesn't want to do. So now we know what that answer is going to almost a running game and through the air to the back out of the backfield.
And he said those little checkdowns, they're called bunts. And Mike Leach doesn't like the bunt.
No, he doesn't.
Hey, if a bunt looks like that, though, I'll take it every now and then.
Doubt.
False start on the offense, number 58. 5-yard penalty. Here remains first down.
Cameron Jones was moving. Left guard just from down the road, Starkville High School.
I'm not talking about bunts anymore. I don't need Berkey calling me out on Twitter like he did last time.
But did you get some hacks in today with Lem and the guys over there at Duty Noble?
No bunts. We did get some rips in, though. None off of actually live pitching.
That's right. Three-man rush. Quick hitter. Now leaves second and 10. Our friend Mr. Tebow did not like this swing.
Not bad. That one's getting through. Poking it through the hole. Oh, okay.
Duck snort. I'd put the shift on him every time.
Yeah, he's not hitting anything to the opposite field.
I have a couple of SEC guys starting in the infield in the World Series tonight. Dansby on one side, Bregman on the other. Bulk in motion. A lot of traffic. Another bunt. There's bunts, and then there's those little league bunts where you put it down, they throw it wide at first, you go to second, they throw it over the bag, you go to third, ball ends up at the backstop.
And this can be really frustrating for a defensive coordinator, right? Brad White, got to be able to stay patient. One thing in talking to him, he mentioned some of these drives, they'd be getting 4 and 5 and 6 here. And Stoops would come on the intercom and say, hey, just stick to the game plan. It's okay. We can give those up, keep eliminating the chunk plays. But, man, it's tough as a coordinator to see these little positive plays over and over again. But once you get aggressive, that's when they really hit you.
Third and 2, and there's a big run. Marks takes it down to the 12. Sophomore out of Carver High in Atlanta picks up 10.
Run to the left here behind Charles Cross inside. And Cameron Jones. Good push on the left side of the offensive line. And that was running at KD McDaniel, one of the lighter guys up front there. As Kentucky shifts things around to play more pass rush, less run stopping.
Kentucky held Mississippi State's offense without a score in last year's game at Kroger Field in Lexington. Little shovel pass, Marks to the 5. Now set up second and 2.
That's just a great drive here by Mississippi State. Great patience by Will Rogers. Hasn't pushed the ball or forced the ball downfield, continually taking what the defense is giving him. And this is the area of the field where they've improved the most. Last year, they threw for a lot of yards, but they didn't finish out drives. This year, finishing out more drives with touchdowns than they did last year. Important to cap this one off.
Into the end zone. Incomplete, flag coming. Leading to the win last year, they picked off State 6 times. Andre Mosley with a hold on Mekhi Polk.
Pass interference on the defense, number 21. The foul occurred in the end zone. The ball being placed at 2 yard line. Automatic first down.
Yeah, Mosley just hooks in there. Anytime you spin the shoulders of that receiver, that's an easy call for that back judge.
Elsewhere in the SEC, Matt Corral has re-entered the game for Ole Miss on the road in the Plains.
What?
Against Auburn, yeah. He just came back out. Like Willis Reed.
Now Paul Pierce there.
Was Pierce really hurt?
No. I think he just had a little accident.
False start on the offense, number 58, 5 yard penalty. It remains
going first backwards. There's a second flag on Cameron Jones. Cole, they had to shuffle some guys around on the offensive line. No excuse for Jones, though, starting in his normal spot at left guard.
No, Quatrevious Johnson's out. Cole Smith, who started most of their games at center last year, has gone to right guard. Got the start there tonight. Actually, nice drive from Cam Jones. He's been up at the second level a couple times on the runs that State busted out.
Here's Marks. Great vision and power! And he's in for a State score. Cole Smith paved the way for Jaquavius Marks.
That's a huge answer for Mississippi State, an extremely efficient drive. And just when it looked like they were headed in the wrong direction, like we all thought, a run.
Yeah. Why not?
Just as predicted. Oh, a doink. Well, glancing right through. State will take it. They bunted their way to 7. State's on the board in a 10-7 game.
SEC Saturday Night, presented by T-Mobile, is brought to you by B. It's What's for Dinner, and new Coca-Cola Zero Sugar, and Wendy's Hot and Crispy Fries. Try the best combo ever today.
The Air Raid has one of the most colorful backgrounds in all of college football history as an offense. Began Iowa Wesleyan with Hal Mumme's 1990 team. Led an NAIA in passing offense. Mike Leach, his OC, was also part-time sports information director at Iowa Wesleyan. They go down to Valdosta State. That's where they actually introduced the Air Raid moniker. And then Kentucky with Tim Couch, number one overall pick in the 99 draft. Mike Leach used to rollerblade around his Lexington neighborhood with the old school Walkman on. Asked him about it. He said, well, yeah, it was, you know, rollerblades. It's a great exercise right there. I'm not going to run. A rollerblade. Chance for a return. This is Zach Johnson, and he goes to the 25. So Mike Leach rollerblades his way to Lubbock as the head coach there. A couple of 6,000-yard seasons. That's Graham Harrell in his grasp there. They had some great quarterbacks, obviously. Same thing at Washington State. Led the country in passing yards per game for 4 seasons.
I mean, just like on a scale of 1 to 10, rollerblading, like it's maybe a 4 in cardio. I mean, come on. Exercise? What are we doing?
Well,
I mean, it's not saying it's not fun.
I'm more
don't threaten me with a good time, but I don't think you're really breaking a big sweat out there rollerblading.
Probably comes with a fanny pack, right?
It's a good look, man.
I'm more curious what he was listening to on the Walkman. Tavassier smoke. On that first down run, we're halfway through the second quarter, 17 points total on the board. You kind of expect the tempo of this game to stay the same?
I think so. I mean, talking to Liam Cohen, he said, man, the biggest reminder I have for myself is to stay patient even when things aren't positive play after positive play. And he was talking about the ground game, right? This offense runs through the ground game. So even if you have a couple negative plays or it's not hitting like you think, got to stay patient there so we can open up some of the play action.
Here's a reverse. Wendell Robinson trying to find the edge. And he dances his way out of bounds. Talking with Liam about the play calling last week at Georgia, he said, I didn't have a great play calling game. I was too conservative early. I have the better feel for when to start rolling the dice a little bit. Hindsight's 20-20, but he admitted that more games, more reps, get a better feel for his quarterback in his offense.
More trust for his quarterback, right? I mean, if you look at Will Levis' decision-making last week, he was near perfect. So in situations like this, he's not afraid to give him options as you see they go 4 wide.
2-2 techniques for these defensive linemen. They will not stay there. You're going to get some kind of movement in the middle of this front.
Yeah, ball better come out quick. Mississippi State bringing pressure. Linebackers here. Everybody's coming. Levis gets rid of it. Tipped. And it falls incomplete. The tip of the cap to Jolie Dunn, who passed away this week, Cole. They're coming from all directions.
It brings back a lot of bad memories for me, Tom Hart. I had some miserable offensive performances on this field against Jolie Dunn-led defenses. One of the best characters in the history of the SEC, and his group flat-out dominated the Auburn teams that I played on.
Kind of like Zach Arnett's defense. It's unpredictable. It's non-traditional.
They're going to get you from everywhere.
Colin Goodfellow to punt it away. That's a beauty. Jaden Wiley wants to try a return. Broke through the first wave. Got Ballerina down at the 24 after a 54-yard punt, 11-yard return. State trails by a field goal.
You guys keep our eye on what's going on around the country, like Columbus, Ohio, where it's actually Penn State, a 3-touchdown dog nearly into the end zone. They're up 7-0 on the Buckeyes late first. Tom, we're watching it.
I might have to change my CFP prediction if that continues. Pirates in the house tonight. Happy Halloween weekend. We've got a little bit of everything. Mike Leach, a little not traditional tonight. He's running more than he typically does.
I mean, it's Halloween, right? Weird things can happen.
It's full moon. SEC Saturday night presented by T-Mobile.
But again, it's really a product of Kentucky going lighter up front.
Yeah. And sometimes plays just like that act as runs on a 7-yard completion to Tulu Griffin.
And I've seen more aggressive blocking on some of those perimeter games more consistently in this game than I have on film for State first half of this season.
Yeah, I thought last week was the first time I really did see a different attitude on the outside. I know it was Vandy. Kentucky's a little better on the back end here, but
wow, nice move to the outside, Dillon Johnson. So Mike Leach throwing the game plan kind of out the window, reacting to what Kentucky's showed him.
Man, this team can be dangerous when you mix in just a little run, right? I mean, these running backs are so talented, Johnson and Marks. If you just sprinkle it a little more than they're used to, boy, you can find the unique balance, and right now it's working for State.
5 minutes to go here in the first half. Good blocking downfield from the wide receivers, and Jaden Wiley has it. Talking to Mark Stoops this week, he was on the same staff as Sonny Dykes when they're both at Arizona. He said, I saw the air raid every day in practice. It's not that complicated. The route scheme is simple. It's repetitive. I have a pretty good idea on how we're going to defend this thing.
Yeah, he knows the verbiage and really the books out on how to defend it, and it's kind of frustrating because it's you just drop eight, right? And talking to Stoops, he's like, well, you know, you start to make adjustments. Coach Leach has seen it all. You make an adjustment, he's got a better counter. That's when you can get in trouble.
Matter of execution. Rodgers has been doing that tonight. A little bit behind his target, but still good for a first down. That's Austin Williams, the academic All-American.
You kind of think about how practice changes for this offense, for this system. Brad White, Kentucky defensive coordinator, telling us we didn't have run periods this week. There were none. And that's usually an emphasis for every team for multiple practice periods throughout the course of any week during the regular season.
Rodgers 14 of 16 through the air tonight. Make it 15 of 17. Another one for Williams. Gain of 7.
Now this is where if you're Kentucky, you might have to start closing the gap just a little bit on the outside, right? Not change your philosophy entirely, but start to visually make it look more difficult to Will Rodgers pre-snap. You give him that green grass in front of your receiver, he's going to continue to take it over and over all the way down the field.
But it goes back to that word patience, right?
Yeah. And look up here. Pressing, making it a little more difficult.
Rodgers, deep out. Over the shoulder catch made by Christian Ford. There's the answer. 16 yards.
That's why it's a double-edged sword. You start to close the gap. That's when they hit you deep. Look at this throw. I mean, the touch. right over the outside shoulder. It's hard to put into words how difficult that throw is. You're used to throwing touch throws vertically down the field, not towards the sideline. That's a 10 out of 10 on level of difficulty for Will Rogers there.
Third in the country in yards per game. Top five in a lot of other categories. Backside screen. That's another nice play by Tulu Griffin. And by the way, this is about Will Rogers. He's so comfortable in this role as air raid quarterback because he's got a ton of reps now.
Ton of reps. Had some in high school, like you mentioned, but his second year now under Mike Leach, he starts to understand the nuances of spacing. Right? This offense wants to get to green grass. When there's not green grass, it's about the quarterback and the receiver being on the same page about where to attack space in between the zones, and right now hitting on all cylinders.
He is perfect this drive, 6-6. Chop it around on the move, and it gets tripped up. But after he picks up the first down, Yusuf Corker got him, and Rogers a little slow getting up. And he will hobble back to the huddle, or what would normally be a huddle.
You know, he was limping off the sideline at one point earlier. Cole was watching him down there. Didn't look like they were addressing any body part or any specific injury. But
his footwork looks just a little bit off.
Little ginger. Gingerly. There we go. Maybe. That's whatever.
Better. What goes into Moscow Mule?
Don't get me started.
First and goal now for State. Hand off. Wide open hole and a touchdown plunge for Dillon Johnson. Will Rogers, highly efficient, is 17 of 19 through the air. Perfect on that 9-play, 75-yard drive. Cole, tell us about Cameron Jones.
On the left side of this Mississippi State offensive line has continued to excel. 58 Cameron Jones. So he had a nice drive a couple series ago. Getting to the second level. Again, patience. Find the backer, stay on him. Finish for the touchdown.
Region's halftime report coming up shortly. Dari Doring Chizik, Matt Corral injured. We'll update what's going on there at Auburn. Georgia rolls. Fireworks in Nashville, and we're not even kidding. Kentucky offensively. How do they get going?
I don't know. Defensively, Mississippi State's playing great. Already has a pick.
Yeah, how about them finishing drives in the red zone? Something they've been doing well the last couple games.
Yeah, that's a big drive there for State. We'll see you in a few, guys.
All right, Johnny, thanks. Yeah, Missouri Vandy game turned into a barn burner. Missouri getting the win on the road. Kentucky already has one special team score. Nothing doing on that return. Of course, the big game was in Jacksonville. Jordan started his day there. Special thanks to Wheels Up, helping to make travel easier. And getting Jordan here from Jacksonville. Rogers getting some bike time in. Maybe earn a Peloton shirt before the night is over. Ninety-four seconds before the half. Here's Wandell Robinson. He'll duck inside, a bounce outside. I thought at times 2 weeks ago against Georgia and Kentucky tried almost too hard to get Robinson involved.
I mean, partly because they didn't have Josh Ali, right? So they didn't have another legitimate option. But he's their best guy. They got to find ways to get him the ball. Something that you're going to see, maybe not here in two-minute drill, because Mississippi State won't be pressuring as much. But in the second half, I expect much more empty sets for Kentucky. Spread things out. It allows you to see much better when and if Mississippi State's bringing pressure or not.
Oh, and here they come. Pressure straight up the middle. Levis hit as he throws, and it flies incomplete. Boy,
That just shows you how aggressive Zach Garnett is. Normally in 2 minutes, want to keep everything in front of you. They bring the pressure there. It hits home.
Drop both D tackles there on that blitz.
It's not just about who they're bringing, but who they're dropping. Levis was able to come out of that unscathed. You can't say that about everybody. One of the Kentucky players still down. What would have been the pocket after that pressure came?
Yeah, left tackle Dare Rosenthal still down on the field.
LSU transfer. Cole, I think about what State does defensively, and the word that comes to mind is chaos. How does that impact an offensive line?
Well, it makes communication difficult because on every play you have a point linebacker, and that designates where your assignments are. So if I call 55 as the mic, that sets everything from that point to each direction, especially one direction, what we have to maintain. Usually the back and the quarterbacks are going to have everything to the opposite direction. Well, if you've got D tackles that are standing up, or you have linebackers that are walking down in the A gap, and you got everybody overloaded to one side or walking around doing different things, it's very difficult to designate your assignments, call the defense, and even the defense out. And then once that changes even more after the snap, obviously your responsibilities go all over the place. So I think your word is extremely accurate. It's the way that I would like to describe it if someone asked me about it, and very difficult to manage. That's why they have so much success with it.
Mississippi State blitzes on 31% of its opponent's dropbacks. It's the second highest rate in the SEC.
And again, to Cole's point, the more spread you go as a quarterback, the easier it is to make those mic points. Yeah. Right? If you go five wide, the defense has to show you where they're coming from. Because right? You spread the field.
Other part of your point, Tom, 31% they pressure. I would love to know how much they show pressure. Because I bet that's probably close to 80% of the time.
Pressure and perceived pressure from Zach Garnett, who, by the way, had a stopover from San Diego State before he took the job at Mississippi State. He was initially hired at Syracuse. Syracuse is a lovely town. He stayed all of 3 days before State call. Kenneth Horsey has moved to left tackle. Austin Dotson now at left guard for Kentucky. Third down, 5. Three-man rush. Levis finds Ali, got tripped up short of the line to gain. Fourth and 1:15 to go. We got to punt it, right?
Mississippi State. I would think so, but
Mississippi State takes a timeout. The offense hasn't left the field. Punt team is hanging out on the edge.
Yeah, I don't think you.
There's nothing to gain.
No.
Here.
You're only down 4. This offense has just been sputtering all day. The early mistake by Will Levis on the interception. Miscommunication with Wandell Robinson and what could have been a touchdown. Another near interception. It's really been the story. Mississippi State has put a lot of pressure on Will Levis. He's been forced to step up in the pocket, move outside, and a lot of communication between him and Liam Cohen on the sideline to identify where the pressure is coming so you can slide the offensive line and have a clean pocket to operate in.
Just 8 of 13 tonight. Kentucky only 84 total yards to State's 211. No return. It'll take a Kentucky hop and down at the 2. 70-yard punt, long field for State. More football action in 10 seconds. Davis Wade Stadium in Starkville, where Will Rogers has been less than 100% physically, it seems, tonight, but on top of his game, 17-19 for a buck 60. They're slicing him up with paper cuts.
Yeah, you can still see just a little bit of a hobble in that trot out there. But he's been laser focused, so accurate tonight. He's got two timeouts, 96 yards to go, minute and 3 seconds. So it's not ideal, but look for a quick throw here off the bat. If they pick up, get some blocking, pick up 10, 15 yards, maybe they do press the tempo a little bit.
3 yard line, first down.
We'll adjust the spot.
Like he moved it about an inch and a half. Okay, and here we go.
Kentucky going light again. State will try to run it. And a 2 yard gain for Jaquavius Marks. Timeout taken quickly on the other side.
And Kentucky's thinking they can get the ball back here if Mississippi State is content in trying to run out the clock. They still got all their timeouts.
So Will Rogers having a great game so far. Looking at his second and eight now. Tom Hart, Jordan Rogers, cold down on the field. He's obviously not 100% physically, but how in this system does that impact him if he doesn't have great wheels?
Well, they don't get him outside the pocket very much. Yeah. The ball comes out of his hands extremely quickly, so don't ask him to do a ton with his legs. It's obviously still an issue, but not paramount in this offense to be a mobile quarterback.
I don't think Kentucky's going to play a man on this drive, right?
No, they shouldn't.
So where can Mississippi State find chunks of yardage?
Well, it's the quick throws to the outside, the blocking from the receivers. That's where they get their explosives. They haven't been able to generate explosives in this offense. It's all come from quick throws. Making a guy miss, as we've seen Jaquavius Marks a few times do tonight. So with Kentucky calling a timeout there, I wouldn't be surprised if we get a quick throw to the outside. See if he can make something happen.
Kentucky has a pair of sacks. We got movement again on Mississippi State. That is the third false start penalty against the Bulldogs tonight.
False start on the offense, number 63, at the distance of the goal, remains second down.
LaQuinston Sharp, the center. Cole, how does that happen to a center?
It can't happen. It can't. You snap the ball when you move. You don't flinch. You either snap the ball and go or you don't. You can snap the ball and nobody else can move. The play starts.
One day we're going to have to get Cole to tell us how he really feels about center infractions in football. They try to run it again. Got it out of the end zone. No gain. Kentucky's got two timeouts left. They'll stop the clock again.
I'm surprised we didn't see at least one pass there on first and second down, right?
Yeah.
I mean, I know you're backed up, and I know you're trying to be safe, but that's what you do best, right? The perimeter, the efficient throws.
Well, you called the timeout to get the ball back.
Yeah.
So third and 11. Seconds left in the half. Jordan Wright has his left shoe off, heading back to the Kentucky locker room. Not a guy they can afford to lose. They wanted him healthy going forward, key part of this defense, but he was banged up coming in, Cole.
Absolutely. Talked to Brad White before him about the game. He said, we would love to get some quality reps from Jordan Wright. We're not very deep at that Jack linebacker position, especially with how they're going to have to generate a pass rush in this game. Knew he wasn't near 100%, tried to give it a go, and obviously now going to have to take another look at him.
So more time for 32, Trevin Wallace. They'll run it again. And Kentucky will stop the clock again and get the ball back. Jaquez Jones in on the stop. Kentucky will have about a half a field to go on this punt. And I wonder what this discussion could be about. You know, Kentucky came kind of close on State's first punt of the game.
Yeah, that's what they're deciding right now. Right? Do we play for a return, or do we play for a block?
Now, they have a return for a score.
Yes.
State second punt, pardon me. They have a return for a score, and you know Ali can do it. A return gets you better field position, but no timeouts remaining.
Sometimes when you go for the block down here, it makes it much more difficult for Mississippi State to get downfield. So in one way, it gives you a little more green grass.
Wandell Robinson back to return this one, standing on the plus side of the 50.
I wouldn't be surprised if they come after this one.
Tucker Day will be behind the letters in the end zone. He is 9 yards deep. Got it away quick. Robinson gonna scoop. First guy, no. Second guy, yes, they got him. And so 37 seconds remaining. Day did his job, a 50-yard punt under duress. Will Levis has thrown an interception in this game. He's got a whip for an arm. He can flick it now.
Yeah, and right now they're looking at probably needing to get about 30 yards at least to feel comfortable. Excuse me, about 20 yards to feel comfortable with a long field goal. No timeouts. The clock will pause on a first down. They'll have to get the line of scrimmage quick if they complete it.
Four-man rush. Can't afford to take a sack. Got to get out of bounds. And will be knocked out of bounds. Chris Rodriguez. Gain of 12. And got a good chunk of it right there.
Good job by Chris Rodriguez of getting vertical, realizing he had space, and then getting out of bounds to stop the clock. Again, you prefer to work the sidelines, but with 32 seconds, you still have time to work the middle of the field and line up and spike it if you need to.
Ruffalo, the kicker, has a long of 45 this season. I thought I saw movement on the right side. To the out again. And that's a quick 5 yard. Oh, they say out of bounds. Isaiah Cummings did not get his feet down in bounds.
Oh, no. His right foot came down before that left, right?
The right foot.
Correct. Is that left, right, left? Yeah, right foot comes down before the left one does.
And the question is, did he have control?
That play is under review.
The right foot was certainly down, but did he have control before the left foot came down out of bounds?
To me, it looked like it.
Correct.
Yeah. Well, what are we doing here? The right foot definitely comes down in bounds. Let's see if we can tell when does he establish control. Yeah, I mean, to me, that's a clean catch, right?
Sure.
It doesn't have to bring it all the way into the body to establish control. He's got a firm grasp on it. It was a clean catch. The right foot comes down before the left. To me, it's a, they should reverse this one. Yeah.
Mickey Haddock, the replay official on site, with communicator Timothy Fresher and extra eyes back in Birmingham.
Yeah, ball doesn't oscillate, doesn't bobble it.
Oscillate, you're getting fancy.
Yeah, yeah. I did not have that on my bingo card tonight.
Don't ask me to spell it, but I'm gonna, you know.
Did it reciprocate? Or?
So the
is that what? I do not think that means what you think it means.
So they congratulate. Princess Bride, like first half, this thing's kind of dragging a little bit.
Yeah. Anybody want a peanut?
After review, it was a catch. Kentucky will have the ball second down at the 35-yard line.
So second and five.
The runner then went out of bounds.
27 seconds
to start on the snap.
Left and a half.
You mentioned Ruffalo's long. 45, is that what you said?
Yeah, this season, 45.
Yeah, so they still need about 5, 6, 7 yards to feel comfortable. Obviously, I think he can kick it longer than 45, but still would like to pick up a few to be in comfortable field goal range.
His career long is 50. There's the playmaker, Wandell Robinson, part of a trip formation to the top. Pressure up the middle. Levis going deep. It's a bullet. It is past the reach of Josh Ali. 21 seconds remain. And Ali behind.
coverage. You can see Levis having to move off his spot a little bit. And like on the interception, a little too much air, not enough air on this throw here.
So obviously, the first down priority. Clock at 21. If you get another one of those out routes, you get plenty of time left to maybe run a couple more.
Absolutely. Mississippi State going to go man coverage here. For me, I'm looking for Wandale Robinson in man coverage.
Here comes pressure. They get it. Levis complete. Robinson dances down the sideline, and he is brought down out of bounds after a gain. To set him up, a pick up a 21.
In the face of pressure, Will Levis delivers a great throw right there to Robinson. Again, it was man coverage. They brought the blitz. You want to throw into the blitz in those situations, and a lot of field with two routes outside of Robinson just running off.
Another 10 yards picked up by Robinson with a U-turn back in to the middle of the field before getting out of bounds.
Yeah, and now these throws got to go into the end zone or work the sideline to the boundary here.
You have time for completion and a spike, maybe.
Yeah, Levis close.
Fires. Intercepted! Second takeaway for State. This one belongs to Jalen Green.
Isaiah Cummings on the outside just kind of gets into no man's land here. He's forced to inside release, which is exactly what Mississippi State wants. But throwing a vertical route, this is kind of a tweener ball for a quarterback. It's very tough. Do you put it on a line? Really, this play is designed to go over the top to the outside. But because of the inside release, it really puts you in a weird predicament. And Will Levis didn't look confident when that ball came out of his hands. And Mississippi State with a huge play to keep Kentucky from a field goal or 7 points.
Crowd got a little louder when they did a live look-in showing Ole Miss trailing by 10 on the Plains. The time to be a Bulldog. 9 seconds left in the half. Levis has been picked off by Green and Preston tonight. Turnovers becoming an issue once again for Kentucky. Kentucky's lone touchdown this half, punt return. State able to punch it out, and that's how the half will come to an end. Will Rogers will wobble off the field after a sensational first half, 17 of 19 for 160 yards. Coming up at the half, you can watch a live performance from the famous Maroon Band of Mississippi State on SEC Network Plus. Start streaming on the ESPN app. Go down to the field. Here's Cole.
Coach Leach, your secondary down multiple players, but your defense continues to step up and make plays. Why have they been able to do it?
Well, they're playing enthusiastic. I think they're doing a pretty good job doing their jobs. We've only let a couple of them get away from us. We got to keep playing hard, though. This is a good team.
Run plays. Where are these run plays coming from for you on offense tonight?
Oh, they've been there. We got more of them, though, tonight.
Is there a little bit of an issue with Kentucky's defense stemming before the snap?
Oh, they simulated our snap count. They simulated our snap count.
Thanks, Coach.
Yeah.
Led to 3 false start penalties, including one on the center. Mike Leach is dressed up as a running coach tonight, but a little bit different play calling. Speaking of Halloween, let's get to the ghouls back in the studio. They got a lot to talk about. Led, of course, by Dari. Gentlemen.
I do like to be the lead ghoul. No question, Tommy. Thank you much. You guys have a good one. It is the region's halftime report. Mike Leach looked like a man who needs a...
Welcome back to SEC Saturday Night, presented by T-Mobile. What a run for Will Rogers and Mississippi State. 17-19 in the first half. State has a 14-10 lead. Welcome back to Starkville. Tom Hart, Jordan Rogers. I found Mike Leach's box of sprees. And the only thing he must like more than this, his quarterback, because he's completed 11 straight passes to this point. You want some?
I don't think I've ever had sprees.
The original.
No, I don't need any of that.
Those were boxed in 1986.
Was it really? Why didn't you put those on eBay or something? Anyways, football. Will Rogers, he was near perfect. This is how this Mississippi State offense is supposed to look. right? We're always saying, well, they got to run the ball. They got to run the ball. Well, they're not going to, but when they sprinkle it in a little bit and it's effective, it creates havoc for the defense. And right now, Mississippi State's offense looks as good as I've seen it.
Here's a pumpkin. Let's take a look at the first half stat brought to you by Zaxby's. We should call him Zats. 56 rushing yards for Mississippi State doesn't seem like much, but that's way more than they're used to. And 216 yards of offense. Two turnovers that killed Kentucky. Really, the only production for the Cats came on a punt return.
Yeah, it's been the mistakes on offense. The story of the first half. Kentucky's got to get back to running the football, and they got to find a way to slow down this run a little bit for Mississippi State, which seems like something I should never have said. Do they get heavier up front? See if they make any adjustments in the second half.
Cole, what did Mark Stoops say?
Talked about the balance really in this game, not just for him offensively, but also the balance between how Mississippi State is handling their offense and then obviously how Kentucky is handling their offense. He said, listen, not a lot of yards with Mississippi State rushing the football, but the balance is what's allowing the defense to have issues. We talked to him about those alley defenders and how Will Rogers hitting some quick throws and then losing contain, not being able to have contain, has been an issue. That conflict defender has to step up in the second half. Coach Stoops said it was something that they addressed in the locker room at halftime.
What is the mascot doing there?
I have no idea. He just walked up on me, and here he is.
So Cole will hip check a back judge, but he'll just let a Wildcat come and hang out with him. Jacquez Jones delivered a smack to Jaquavius Marks.
Well, Cole mentioned those alley defenders. So anytime you get a little lighter up front, you go to this more three-down drop-eight structure, those outside linebackers have a tough job. They got to be in coverage a lot, but they also have to set the edge against the run. And right now, they're not doing a good job or good enough job of setting the edge against the run. That's why Mississippi State has found some success.
Now, 13 straight completions for Rogers. Marks dances his way for a gain of 8, and that's going to leave third and short.
It's just creating more space between assistants. You see right there, 13's your alley defender. It takes him a long time to get back out there and help get an extra hat to get the ball carried to the ground. It's creating more space, more grass for those edge alley defenders to be able to cover.
Devontae Robinson exits. Vito Tisdale takes his spot. They're going to run it, needing one. They'll get that and more. Dillon Johnson, sophomore out of Greenville, Mississippi.
Yeah, here's that alley defender not being able to set the edge right here. Watch how much movement Mississippi State gets on the edge right there. That's why that, and the run goes right behind it. That's that defender we're talking about. They have to be able to drop in coverage, but also be firm at the point of attack. And that time, J.J. Weaver didn't hold up against the run.
Already 63 yards on the ground, more than their season average per game, by 14 yards, and we've just started the second half. Movement up front. So cold, and we got another false start. Let's go back to what Mike Leach told you going off the field. He said Kentucky was simulating State snap count.
Now, to me, it looks like it's a stem by the defensive line, which is fine. If you want to move your defensive line, everybody moves at once, like over one gap, either direction. But if you verbalize that, or if there's a clap that goes with it, that's where I think a coaching staff would say, hey, you're simulating our snap count. That's obviously illegal.
It may be hard for us to hear or for viewers to hear over the television set, but this SEC officiating crew should be able to identify that if that's happening as Leach described. We got a flag on that run by Dillon Johnson. That's going to back State up even further.
That's usually fairly easy to identify, right? If that's really happening, Mississippi State offensive lineman as well as Mike Leach would make that known to the ref.
Holding on the offense number 67. 10-yard penalty from the previous spot. We will replay first down.
And they'd pay a little more attention to it. But even if it's not directly simulating whatever the sound of the snap is, as an offensive lineman and being down there as a quarterback at times, it can be a violent sound along with the movement. That can just make you jump. It doesn't have to sound like a snap count, but just that movement associated with a sound oftentimes gets those offensive linemen jumpy.
If you're a D lineman and you hear a snap count as go, obviously if you come up and you want to stem your D line, your signifier to do that is going to be go. Yeah. It's going to sound just like the snap count.
Yeah.
Comes with a clap and then the snap. They get to the outside. Marks gets 8 yards back. Second and 17 coming up.
You've seen Georgia do it a lot this year. They're having a ton of success with stemming before the snap defensively. And listen, that's a group that doesn't need to give people extra problems. But Kirby Smart and Dan Lanning have done it a lot this year. What it does is create a lot of missed assignments because, you, like going back to what we talked in the first half, you identify the defense, and then boom, all of a sudden they're in a completely different front, and you're out of time to be able to realign everything.
Second and 17. State only has one play at 20 yards or more in this game. That's caught for first down by Jaden Wally. And a chunk play of 22 yards. Second longest of the game for State on cue.
We talked about patience for defensive coordinator Brad White. This time, not patient. You rush forward. You're tired of the quarterback having too much time. You're tired of the running game getting extra yards. You add an extra defender to the rush. You leave an opening downfield. That's when Mississippi State hits those big plays, as I said earlier.
Fourth catch for Wally. Marks finds four.
It's just a waiting game,
yeah.
Right? I mean, Mississippi State is fully content with taking short throw after short throw, mixing in a run here as long as you're dropping eight. You add an extra guy, now that's a regular coverage. That's what they want. They have numbers on the back end. That's when those throws open up downfield. There hasn't been many of them, but they capitalized on it as soon as Kentucky made an adjustment.
We saw that a few weeks ago with State's big win on the road at Texas A&M before the Aggies beat Alabama. Here's Marks on a toss. They were going dink and dunk and dink and dunk down the field. Mike Elko came out of that. They went from dink and dunk to chunk, and that was the difference in the game.
Dump by Wallace. Gain of three, third and three.
There's definitely a hitch in his getting as Rodgers moves around the field. He had the shoulder injury against Alabama. That didn't seem to be an issue against Vanderbilt.
Now he's been on the bike, though, in between drives as well, trying to stay loose. At one point, thought it was his back. Now maybe an ankle or something. Something's obviously not right, but he's playing through a little bit of pain and still playing at a high level.
Back to the ground game. Marks, big hole. Marquez Bembry first there, only after he picks up seven.
Just zone to the front side. Scott Lashley, the right tackle, does a good job of just staying on Fitzgerald there. And a great read by Marks to cut that back and get vertical quickly.
Opening drive, second half for State. Kentucky mixes it up, and it is nearly picked. Yusuf Corker had it.
Wow. Eerily similar to that throw we saw earlier in the game from Will Rogers that I praised him on, right? The touch throw to the outside. It's such a difficult throw. And that time, just not enough room. And Yusuf Corker, that he had it.
Abuli Abadi Fitzgerald had dropped in coverage from his defensive tackle spot. That was 15 straight to that point hit by Rodgers. Ends a nice little streak. 10th play of the drive. Stands in the face of pressure to find Dillon Johnson. And we got a flag at the end. Corker with the horse collar. He's saying, hey, I just had him by the shoulder pad.
Personal foul, first collar tackle on the defense number 29. That penalty will be enforced from the end of the run at the distance to the goal, automatic first down.
And again, it doesn't have to be in the shoulder pads. Up and around the nameplate of that jersey is going to get called. And that's for player safety, right? A lot of times leg injuries will happen to the ball carrier there when you get dragged down a weird way.
Side or front, that's a legal tackle. Once it comes from the back.
Yes, correct.
Changes things. First and goal now. Marks into the end zone. Flag came flying after the 10-yard run in the midst of it.
holding on the offense number 58. 10-yard penalty from the spot of the foul. We will replay first down.
That's Cameron Jones, who had a really good block on a, I believe, a touchdown run earlier.
Yeah. Cole did the replay and everything.
Yeah.
Third flag this drive for Mississippi State's offense.
A left guard here.
Tough to see from that angle.
Yeah. Tough to tell if he got any jersey there. Obviously, the defender trying to work away from him. That's when that call usually happens. A big penalty to push Mississippi State back to the edge of the red zone.
Whoa. What do we got?
False start on the offense, number 57, 5-yard.
You saw Will Rogers go straight towards the middle linebacker. I wasn't sure who it was, pointing out to the officials probably what Leach was talking about. Seventh different offensive line penalty tonight. And if Leach is saying they're simulating our snap count, Rogers is trying to point it out to the crew.
Absolutely. And see if we can see anything here. Just lean in a little bit again. The refs down there on the field will be the ones to determine if there's any foul play going on with simulating that cadence or not.
Shovel marks, blown up. J.J. Weaver there, loss of three.
Boy. Penalties will take the wind out of your sails, huh?
Yeah.
I mean, Mississippi State just had so much momentum, driving all the way downfield, got inside the 10-yard line. A touchdown run, called back for a holding. A false start. A negative play, now you're at the 28-yard line.
One thing I noticed on that touchdown run, they changed the snap count with a little delay.
Yeah.
See if they can get it changed here again.
Second and goal. Down to the 10. Down to the 6 is Mekhi Polk. Nice touch. Gain of 22.
And this is the difference, Will Rogers, from last year to this year. The ability to change the trajectory of the football, throw up and over defenders. You have to be able to do that against zone-dropping teams, especially drop-A teams, as Mississippi State faces so often. The ability to throw accurately with touch is such an underrated attribute for a quarterback. Everyone wants to see the big arms. Everyone wants to see the laser rocket throws. That throw right there is even more important.
13th play of the drive. Marks doesn't get the blocking he needed on the edge. Corker there for a loss of three.
White Corker. Again, he's been in coverage deep down the field. He's playing at the line of scrimmage. The ability to run the ball for State is really stressing the responsibilities of these second and third level players for Kentucky. But a great job getting a stop after what looked like surely was going to be a Mississippi State scoring drive before the couple penalties.
27-yard attempt for Brandon Ruiz. Stinger right through. Mississippi State takes a touchdown advantage. Bulldogs controlling the clock here in the second half. Starkville, let's take a look at Fansville. Brought to you by Dr. Pepper. Earlier today, trick and treating going full bore.
You dressing up?
I haven't thought about it yet.
So you're not?
Yeah.
If you haven't thought about it.
Too late.
You know, sometimes, though, the best Halloween costumes are those panic day of costumes.
Yeah, whatever you come up with.
Yeah. Go over to the, what's the Halloween store?
Yeah, Party City, maybe. Party,
and they got nothing left, but you're like, oh, I'll be the one that nobody wanted.
Sure.
It's the wrong sign, but let's do it.
That's how Tom ended up being Barbie last year.
What's up with Kentucky's offense today?
Well, it's been struggling to really get going. We talked about how important Wandale Robinson is to this offense, but Mississippi State has had him bottled up at the line of scrimmage. They've tackled him well in space, and it's really been about the decision-making from Will Levis. The interception earlier, didn't throw the ball in a line. The miscommunication here with Isaiah Cummings on an inaccurate throw as well. Can't turn the ball over. But really, Kentucky's got to get back to the ground game, right? This is the identity of their offense.
So Will Levis came to Kentucky from Penn State. You see the play selection as they try to get Chris Rodriguez Jr. involved. And he gets just 1 yard. Cole, why isn't Kentucky able to have success with their ground game tonight?
Well, number one, I don't think they've been committed to it. And then number two, gap scheme runs like that you just saw right there. When you have a penetrating defense, when they get north and south, you knock multiple linemen off their tracks. You're unable to get to your blocks. It's just a lack of recognition, lack of understanding of what's coming. And that's tough. You talked about it earlier, Tom. Difficult to diagnose what you're going to get from this defense.
Rodriguez came in leading the SEC with 775 yards in this season. Lost the football! Picked up by Jet Johnson! Another Kentucky turnover. And State firmly in the driver's seat now. This is one that's really tough as a running back, right? You're looking for a flash of color. The ball is not firmly in his belly. The handoff was a little bit off. And he ends up running into his own guy here. Oh, I mean, that handoff is where it needs to be. Rodriguez didn't clamp down on it right away. Got a little bit on the outside, and then he runs into his own guy. Just too many times 24 has put the ball on the ground.
Mississippi State has possessed the ball for all of 42 seconds, all but 42 seconds in this second half. Kentucky with another tackle behind the line of scrimmage. Josh Pascal showing up.
It was a little bit of a newer run from Kentucky there, too. I haven't seen much duo in this game.
What is duo?
Duo is offensive line is going to concentrate on the double teams. It's going to look like zone to the right, but you're focusing on the cutback. So it's going to target back to the left. It's just a different track and a different style play for the running back.
On second and 12 to throw. Seven in protection. Wide open. Down to the one is Jaden Wally. Will Rogers finding levels.
Finding levels is right. But the reason that throw was made is him looking to the left and coming back right.
Here's Dillon Johnson, and here's another State score. The offense running wide open now. The first half, the Bulldogs had one play of 20 yards plus, already three in the second half.
This is the best I have seen this Mississippi State offense in 2 years under Mike Leach. And Will Rogers playing one of his best games as well.
.24 unanswered for Mississippi State.
Well, it was the pass from Will Rogers that got them down right into the goal line. Watch how he works left, moves the secondary defenders, comes back right, little touch on the throw in traffic over the middle of the field. And then, hey, just because they throw it all the time doesn't mean that they can't hand it off every now and then. This run game has been the difference for Mississippi State, now up 14.
Saturday Night, presented by T-Mobile, is brought to you by new Coca-Cola Zero Sugar and Wendy's Hot and Crispy Fries. Try the best combo ever today. And Barbecue Guys, for those who were born to grill.
What a run. Dak even loved it in Omaha for the Mississippi State baseball team. First ever national championship. Great tradition here. Thunder, Lightning, Papelbon, Bangum, all the way through.
in the best baseball stadium in all of college baseball, finally bringing home a national title. Won the last two games in Omaha in championship series by a combined score of 22-2. Honored tonight, got their championship rings. No return. Cole, we're looking at footage of the baseball team on the field. What you learned hanging with Chris Lemonis earlier today?
Oh, first thing I learned being inside Duty Noble on that field, Tom, did not want to leave. Just the place is just spectacular. It's beautiful. You just want to go play catch, take a little BP, run around the outfield out there. But Chris Lemonis is just fun to be around. There's obviously no question as to why his players want to play for him, want to play hard for him. Beautiful facility, and then just to meet some of the guys, be around them today, pretty cool. And by the way, the rings are bling-tastic.
Bling-tastic?
I didn't know that was a word.
It is now.
Kentucky desperate to A, take care of the football, and B, find a way to pick up some first downs. Levis fakes the pitch. That is intercepted! Another state takeaway! Fourth of the night! Cameron Young got him off the carom. Tyus Wheat set him up. Will Levis cannot believe what he just saw.
Boy, you can't even chalk this one up.
Warning, Mississippi State, this is their
to Will Levis, this is just a great play by Tyrus Wheat. Fake pitch on the outside. Wheat drops into coverage, but he's just reading Will Levis's eyes. Instead of dropping away, he starts to go with Will Levis's eyes, gets a hand up, tips and overthrows. That's what defenses want to see. There's just nothing you can do there. What a frustrating night for this Kentucky offense and Will Levis.
Last in the SEC in turnover margin. Cole, you mentioned it's been so good. But in a game like this, where they're evenly matched, turnovers, killer. Marks and Johnson in the backfield. Dillon Johnson tries a hurdle. What a difference a year makes, huh? Last year, Kentucky had six picks of the Mississippi State quarterbacks. And a +5 turnover margin in the game tonight. Mississippi State +4.
And this right here kind of feels like a drive of the game, right? It can get out of hand if Mississippi State ends up punching it in here, but this Kentucky defense can hold tight here.
A record-setting throw to Mekhi Polk with that completion. Will Rogers just surpass Dak Prescott in career completions, single-season completions, 317. That is a career for some guys.
Yeah, for most guys. They throw it around. Big third down here. This Kentucky defense can get off the field, force a field goal attempt. Maybe that's a little bit of the momentum that can help this offense get back on track.
What in the world?
Everybody moves, center didn't snap
start.
It.
On the offense, number 78, 5-yard penalty, remains third down.
I tell you what I like right there, though. I like Cole Smith, a former center, now playing guard, looking back at his quarterback and saying, hey, buddy, center doesn't need you getting into him right now. He knows he just made a mistake. Get back there in shotgun. Do what you got to do. Clap. Call out the whatever. All the routes and whatnot. We'll handle everything up here.
Big quarterback looked pretty, but it's a sixth false start on his Bulldog offensive line tonight. Late blitz. Rogers going deep. Man caught. Touchdown. Mississippi State with another 20-plus yard play. 26 yards to Thomas. Mike Leach says you're doing a pretty good job. 27 of 30 for Will Rogers tonight.
That's ridiculous. Truly. Stoops was down yelling at the ref. Not sure if he thought they should take another look at that one. They won't.
Kentucky's dream season being derailed here in Stark Vegas tonight. Down three touchdowns. Ra-Ra Thomas, catch, control, and maybe. Regardless, it's all maroon now. After further investigation, we understand why Mark Stoops was so upset. This was ruled a touchdown. They did not stop play to review it. Doesn't mean they didn't review it, but when we took a second look, ball is on the ground. No catch.
Yeah, it really wasn't. And every look, you pretty much have a clear view of this ball moving. You see, Mosiak does a good job right there of getting his hand in. And yes, the catch was made initially, but you have to survive the ground. And he didn't. That should have been reviewed. Should be an incompletion.
Instead, it's another score for Mississippi State. Up 31-10. So now it's up to Will Levis to try and get things right. 11-19, no touchdowns, three picks tonight. The last one on a batted ball. Three picks and a lost fumble for Kentucky. Here's Wandale Robinson.
And also what we haven't seen, obviously Kentucky has struggled running the football effectively, and Will Levis has had his issues throwing the football. We haven't seen design quarterback runs.
I was going to ask you about that, because Will Levis, when he was at Penn State, here's Kavasi Smoke, stop short. He was a run-first quarterback,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
So now you bring him into this offense based on what the Rams do in the NFL. They're asking him to be much more of a passer than he's ever been before, at least at the collegiate level.
Yeah, but there's been games where they've used him, just hasn't been a designed run tonight, and against a really good Mississippi State defense, especially run defense, top 10 in the entire nation, I would expect a little more of that. Add an extra hat, get your big physical quarterback. Aside from a QB sneak,
which is
the ability to run
tonight.
The football. Yeah.
Not to mention, you force them to defend it, and at least they're aware of it.
And that, in turn, can open up things downfield. So, look, game plans are fluid, right? Talking to Liam Cohen, we realize that. You kind of figure out how the game's going, how a defense is playing you, and you start to adjust things. Obviously, Kentucky hasn't had many opportunities this half, so you're seeing now the adjustments that Liam Cohen is making in this game plan.
There's Robinson with an 18-yard completion.
That's another thing I love to see. Get your athletic quarterback outside the pocket. He's had some trouble seeing things from in the pocket. You've had some batted balls. Great way to counter that. Good route and an accurate throw.
Earlier this season, we're talking to Mark Stoops about Will Levis's inefficiency at quarterback, especially with the turnovers. And he is so enamored with Levis's strong arm. There's been very little thought of saying that there could be a change made at that position. Here's Rodriguez. And he said, listen, what we haven't had here in a few years is a quarterback that can really stretch the defense and can go deep. And Will Levis has the ability to do that, and that's what our offense is predicated on. Obviously, run first for the most part with this offense.
And the two shot plays tonight have one ended up in an interception, the other one in an overthrow to Josh Ali in the end zone.
Levis shovels it away. What a play. Rodriguez gets undone inside the 30. And Levis just made something out of nothing.
Ah, what a heads up play here. You're going to see blitz come late from the right side. Levis never sees it until it's right in his face. And it's just a great natural reaction to find your check down and get the ball to him however possible. A little underhand, a little Favre-like there.
Yeah, whatever you got to do. Injured Mississippi State player will stop the clock with 26 seconds left in the third quarter. Rodriguez bothered with a fumble tonight, but trying to get back in it. It's a Mississippi State team, by the way, that's been tonight light in the secondary. Fred Peters We're not playing this game due to injury. We knew that coming in. And then early on, Martin Emberson was ejected for this game, from this game for targeting. So they've had to go pretty deep.
And credit to them. They've held up on the outside.
Sean Preston Jr. had that pick early, and he is the injured Bulldog playing in Peter's spot.
Cameron Richardson has played well, being thrust into a little bit bigger role on the outside.
Preston, a fourth-year junior from St. James, Louisiana.
Well, you go against Chris Rodriguez in the open field, you got to get your pad level down. Maybe a little stinger there.
Rodriguez, 224 pounds, got 20 of them on Preston. Cats averaging 8 yards a play this drive. Levis fires over the middle. Batted away. Colin Duncan. A flag down. Near the line of scrimmage, you're actually back where the pocket was.
Holding on the offense, number 61. 10 yard penalty from the previous spot. In the new play, first down.
Austin Dotson.
See Dotson at left guard here. That little inside move, he gets beat by Sherman Timms, and that's just a late throw. That ball's got to be out of the quarterback's hands. Those seam routes, you have to hit those from 18 to 22 yards. If it's longer than 22 yards, those corners and safeties are able to undercut the seam routes. It's got to be three steps and ripped. Little slight hesitation by Levis, and that one had no chance.
Levis under center. Handoff. Rodriguez. 6 yard gain. Three quarters down.
Three score
lead. Mississippi State up 31-10. Back to Starkville after this. Mississippi State on top of Kentucky 31-10 as we start the fourth quarter. Zach Arnett's defense with three interceptions and a fumble recovery. And it's almost, Cole, an homage to what Jolie Dunn, the late Jolie Dunn, had passed away this week, one of college football's great coordinators, did.
Boy, Tom, you talked about the similarities as just to how these defenses operate. Jolie Dunn, one of the great characters in the SEC. This league can make coaches famous, but you got to go out and earn it, and Jolie Dunn did that. I talked to Kevin Slater, a defensive lineman that played for him in the 90s earlier this week, and he said, you know, Jolie Dunn's best attribute was finding guys like me that weren't big enough, strong enough, fast enough to play at other places, and giving them a role and allowing them to be successful. Talk about putting in that defense with no defensive lineman's hands on the back. Experience in 4 years playing against Jolie Dunn, we ran the ball 126 times for 149 yards, one touchdown. Misery!
By all accounts, Jolie Dunn only wore socks on the sideline once, and that was in the Snow Bowl. Third and 12.
Josh Ali going to have a favorable matchup here in the slot.
Ripped to the outside, complete for a first down. DeMarcus Harris with his first catch of the game.
And I thought this was going to be an area of the field where it was going to be a good on good matchup all night. Mississippi State defense has been so good in the red zone, top 10 in the country at stopping touchdowns. In Kentucky, traditionally really good in the red zone, have not converted tonight. They have to convert here.
Levis fires, caught. Kentucky touchdown, back to back to DeMarcus Harris. A much needed scoring drive by the Cats. 10 plays, 75 yards.
one. A great job by Levis to stay confident. Nothing's gone right. Look at him work his shoulders here a little bit. Little pump moving underneath defenders to make sure he has a clear path to throw that corner out. Great job manipulating the defense there really quickly, right? I mean, he had no time to do that. The ball had to be out, but still moved a defender, ripped it on target, on time. To keep Kentucky in this one, at least.
Well, I tell you what, if Kentucky can operate like that offensively, we could be in store for a circus finish. Turnovers have doomed Kentucky to this point, but Will Levis finding his rhythm late.
Dory Noka in studio, time for our comeback moment, supplemented by Aflac. You know, Georgia came back. What did they come back from? Last year's loss to Florida. You want another comeback? Watch this. N'Kobe Dean. Catch it. He going to come back the other way. All kinds of comebacks in Georgia's 27-point rout of their arch rivals from Gainesville.
Dar, that's the kind of play that make a Georgia radio announcer break his chair. Go right through the steel and the padding. Been burning down all those vacation condos. Little punch on the kickoff, and it's going to turn into a nasty return for Mississippi State and Tulu Griffin. Nice return. Let's look at our hometown connection brought to you by T-Mobile. Each week we highlight a team's connection to towns across the SEC. We go down to the Gulf for this one. Bulldogs redshirt senior Austin Williams from Ocean Springs owns an undergrad degree in finance, pursuing his master's in business administration. Coach Leach awarded him with his plaque for being named first team academic All-American, four-time member of the SEC Fall Academic Honor Roll, semifinalist this season for the Campbell Trophy, the academic Heisman. Cole, how close are you to being an academic All-American?
As far away as you can get, it's still being eligible.
What was the GPA looking like in college?
Yeah, what was your GPA?
2.5 kept you eligible. It was 2.51 every semester. Listen, I was a business major, and we started out with the first level of economics, which I think they split it in fours. If you were dumb like I was, I got through half of it, dropped it, and I went to my counselor, and I said, listen, give me the majors available with the least math possible. Communication ended up being one of those. I think the lowest tier math you could take was 159. They got me into like a 141 somehow. We had a TA for a teacher. His name was Zhang. And he gave us a quiz every single Friday. And he left the classroom after he handed out the quiz every single Friday. You can ascertain for yourself how I got through the one math class that I graduated at Auburn and thankfully now have a diploma on my wall.
I loved classes like that.
The best. Tough equation for Kentucky, though. Vito Tisdale being helped off the field, not putting much weight on that left leg.
And he played a big role tonight all over the field. Took the brunt of that, kind of lowered his head there.
The previous play is under review for a possible fair catch signal.
I don't think I've seen a review on this before.
Anything's possible.
Well, shoot, if Cole can pass math, then yeah, we can have a review on a fair catch.
If he would get a diploma from college instead of a degree, then yeah.
If the officials step out of the classroom when you kick off, I guess you could review anything.
All right, it doesn't have to be much of a fair catch signal. That to me was gaining balance.
Right, do you give someone the benefit of the doubt there? Because the defense, the kick coverage team there, they see that.
Yeah, if it goes over your shoulder, they're going to rule that was a fair catch signal, even though it seems evident to us that wasn't the intent.
Yeah, it looked like he was just kind of doing the windmill to slow down a little bit. You know?
After review, video evidence shows that the runner gave a fair catch signal after the ball hit the ground. By rule, the ball will be placed at the 10-yard line, first and 10, Mississippi State.
30-yard difference. At the end of that run, a return that will be negated due to the fair catch signal.
Yeah, again, and I don't think it was purposeful, but as a referee, you can't say, oh, I don't think he meant to.
No,
right?
As soon as the arm goes up, above the shoulder pads.
Absolutely, because the kick coverage team, as soon as they see that, they're not deciphering, oh, did he mean to put his hand up? Nope, his hand was up. It was moving. That's the right call there. And a big call for Kentucky.
Kentucky needed a break.
Yeah, huge. Huge swing in field position.
There's Williams in motion. If Rodgers can stay on rhythm, finds Williams. So one of the differences we're seeing from Mississippi State's offense tonight versus what we've seen in games past is being held to 4-5 yards of completion. Boy, there's a huge difference between 4 or 5 and 8.
Yeah. Enormous, right? 4 you can live with every now and then, an incompletion or a negative play, then you can have a stop. But when you're getting chunks of 7 and 8 into soft zone, it's just demoralizing.
And it's more than just the yardage difference, right? It's the accumulation of those yards when they run so many plays and they have a time of possession advantage. And Rodgers has barely missed tonight. He's 28 of 31.
That's so hard to do. I mean, again, I don't care if it's short throws, long throws. I don't care if it's routes on air in practice. It's difficult to be that accurate.
I don't do that in Tecmo Bowl very often.
Cole, quickly, what's his completion percentage? Do the math.
89.
That actually might be close.
He's averaging over 10 yards of completion. That one goes for 12.
We spoke with Austin Williams just about the difference year one to year two, and he just mentioned the feel, right? This route right here, this is a feel route. This is a route where the receiver's got to start to throttle down because he sees zone coverage out in front. Not stop, but slow down just enough to give your quarterback an area to throw the football, and he did it there. Shows the chemistry that they built from last year to this.
How about the play selection for Mississippi State tonight? 58 plays. 26 of them runs.
I would have bet all the money in my bank account, which isn't a ton, that it wouldn't even been close, right? I mean,
yeah.
If you'd have told me, hey, at the end of the game, you know, they maybe only have 6 or 7 more passes than rushes, I've said, you're talking about what team? No,
not
no chance.
Squad.
The run game's been effective tonight.
Another 300-yard passing game for Will Rogers. Another completion going to Dillon Johnson. And another injured player, Dillon Johnson, slow to get up, if at all. State has dominated time of possession, 30 minutes to 18 minutes, give or take. Yeah, Mark Stoops having a frustrating night here in Starkville again. Completion to Johnson. Took a big hit, and he's still down on the field for the Bulldogs.
SEC Saturday Night is presented by T-Mobile, the leader in 5G, America's largest, fastest, and most reliable 5G network, and in part by new Coca-Cola Zero Sugar and Wendy's Hot and Crispy Fries. Try the best combo ever today.
The top four teams and the first two teams looking in. So let's have a look at the bracket. We're going to start at number one. The number one team, according to the selection committee, is Mississippi State.
Yeah, there we go. And the CFP rankings coming out Tuesday night. First of this season, 3rd and 3. Rodgers going deep. It is a flag on the play. Whether or not Griffin was inbounds or not, he did catch it, but I guess they ruled he was out of bounds, but left pass interference after it anyway. Now ruled incomplete or signaled incomplete, and then they'll have the PI.
Pass interference on the defense number 3. 15-yard penalty from the previous spot. Automatic first down.
That's Cedric Dort, Jr.
The result of the play was an incomplete pass.
Yeah, Dort Dort does a great job of being in phase right here, but you got to find the ball. As soon as you see that receiver slow down and start to posture like the ball is coming, you got to turn and let your body wall him out. He's so close to the sideline there, you don't need to use your hands. Turn and your momentum can wall him out. As long as you're looking back for the ball, it wouldn't get called. You start to get those hands involved, that's an easy flag.
Back to the running game. Kentucky's got it sniffed out. Wallace there. No gain. Tuesday night, 7 o'clock on ESPN, the first CFP rankings release. The way the season has gone for Kentucky to this point, figured that they could end up with a favorable spot on the first rankings release and continue to climb, but if they can't exit Starkville with a win, those dreams will be dashed. Lone loss for the Cats came against Georgia between the hedges. It'll be interesting to see what happens in the Big Ten. Penn State and Ohio State tied 17 all in the third. Rogers going to run with it now. Six-yard run on the QB scramble.
And got up a little gingerly there, too. Obviously working through a little pain there. A little something hasn't been right, but a great job because Kentucky had everything covered. They got so much depth with their linebackers that there was a lot of green grass, and Will Rogers took advantage of it to get them in a better third down scenario. Brad White forced the issue a couple times early, bringing pressure.
Timeout.
We'll see with a little time to think about it on third down if he decides to bring pressure once again.
It'll leave a third and five. Let's look at the road to the championship brought to you by Mercedes-Benz. All right, so you guys put your picks in with a more chaos in college football today. You each got Georgia number one. Cole's got Alabama in the top four, and you don't.
No, I don't. I mean, I think right now you honor the wins. And I think Michigan State just had a monster win against Michigan today, so I moved them up. Alabama's going to have every opportunity to prove that, so I got them just on the outside looking in right now.
I like the fact that Alabama has wins against Ole Miss, Miami, Florida. This Mississippi State team that we're watching tonight, Tennessee's better than we thought they were going to be. There are not a lot of teams that have multiple massive wins on the season. Jordan's right about Michigan State. Excellent win today. I don't know if there's another one on their schedule outside of Miami that you can look at and say is a very good win, much less a monster win.
Tom, did you put your analyst hat on?
I did. You tried to put one on, but it wouldn't fit over that hair for 3 years ago.
Isn't that bad?
Can we get an updated photo?
I got to get a new headshot. It's just horrible. You should see it on the side of the Nation bus. I'm embarrassed.
Just put it over the muffler.
Can't believe you ever let me wear my hair or my face like that.
Third and five. Here's Marks. And he gets taken down. No gain. That will bring up fourth and five. There you go.
Speaking of headshots.
Yeah.
I'm so happy
that you guys weren't around. Michigan State big win against Michigan. Cincinnati, I got in at number two. Notre Dame is about to go to 7-1 by knocking off North Carolina tonight.
Ooh.
Their only loss coming to that Cincinnati team. So that's tough to find a bigger win than that. Cole was talking about big wins.
That's a fake smile.
Of course it is.
At least mine was genuine.
You were in the room. And Ohio State in a battle with Penn State. I feel like you have to have Oregon in front of Ohio State. They got a head-to-head win without their best player in Columbus. Sky-high punt. Won't carry long, but it'll get some hang time. And it looked like George Wedge checked up, came back. Just a 16-yard punt. Kentucky's got to make hay. Take a look at the five-star play of the game brought to you by Yellowwood. That's a beaver.
again, this is the story of the night. Kentucky offense turning the football over, but give credit to Mississippi State. They have been getting in passing lanes. They've been putting pressure on Will Levis. They've been making plays on the outside. Yes, mistakes by Levis, but an even better performance by this Mississippi State defense so far tonight.
Good drive last time for Kentucky. Going for a screen. Wandale Robinson gets one block, gets a second, and takes it the rest of the way for a pickup of 12 on first down.
I love this personnel grouping that Kentucky's in right now while they go tempo. They're in 12 personnel, two tight ends. They were just in a five wide set. Now they get into a tight wing set.
Levis going deep. Robinson never made it to his spot. We'll go back to the formations. Is that... Does it smell like the Rams to you?
Oh, it looks exactly like the Rams. I mean, this is an offense that wants to give the illusion of complexity. They want to get in different formations, different personnel groupings, spread you out, condense you in. Look, I mean, the key for this offense is to have a quarterback that can push the ball downfield. Look at Matthew Stafford with the Rams.
Yeah.
The problem is Matthew Stafford has a bunch of playmakers on the outside. Cooper Kupp, Robert Woods. Kentucky's still trying to find who their go-to is outside of Wandale Robinson, as again, Will Levis forces it downfield to Robinson.
Looking for Kavassier's smoke, and that could be grounding. Bookie Watson came after him. We've seen that call grounding this season.
Love the pressure on the play from Zach Garnett. He goes bare defense, so he's going to cover up the center and both guards with two outside defenders that are occupying the tackles, and then you bring that linebacker in the A-gap, there's just nobody home to be able to pick it up.
Third down, 10.
Mississippi State showing pressure. I think they're going to drop out of it, though.
They bring five. Out of the reach of Robinson.
Wow.
Zach, who punted away with just under 8 minutes to go.
Yeah, Mississippi State showed pressure from the field. They dropped out of it, brought a little pressure from the boundary. It was picked up, though. Clean pocket, and this one just got away from Will Levis. Comes a little high and hot out of his hand. Just out of the reach of Robinson.
Fair catch taken at the 25-yard line, 38-yard punt. Plenty to talk about an SEC football final when we finish tonight, including Tyler Beatty going for 254 and two touchdowns at a 73-yard run late. Missouri took care of Vandy. Georgia hammered Florida, and the Matt Corral issue lingering. It's on the SEC Network and the ESPN app when we finish here tonight. Special thanks to Wheels Up, helping to make travel easier. Jordan was at SEC Nation in Jacksonville this morning, here in Starkville for our game tonight. Vito Tisdale back on the field, coming from the edge. And Jaquavius Marks picks up one.
Well, it's half two time for Kentucky defense. You have to get a stop. Down two scores, all 3 year timeouts. Still enough time left, but you can't afford to let Mississippi State pick up one or two first downs here. This game starts to get out of reach.
But what a difference a non-call makes. Because the catch that was in the end zone by Mississippi State, if that is overturned, you're looking at a 24-17 game or maybe a 27-17 game. This was all scoring plays are reviewed, but they did not stop play to further look at this. When we looked at it multiple times, it was an obvious incompletion.
Yeah, and really surprising this one didn't get a second look. You know, the default should kind of be just a, hey, let's stop it, let's look at it on a scoring play.
Make sure you have plenty of time.
Yeah,
no,
totally.
No rush.
Yeah, no reason to rush the extra point, right? So, yeah, that does change the game. You're right. Is it a field goal? Do they end up scoring? I don't know. But that missed call could definitely change the outcome, not the outcome maybe, but the scenario if Kentucky does get the ball back, you know?
DeAndre Square coming off the field for Kentucky. Second and nine. It's been a while since Kentucky has won here. The home team has won the last six in the series. 2008 was the last time Kentucky got a win in Starkville. They needed a block extra point to pull that one off. Randall Cobb was playing for the Cats that night.
Randall was pretty good. We played him in 2010, and he made about everybody on our defense look like they've never played football before.
He still is pretty good.
He still is really good. Two touchdowns the other night.
Second and nine, swing pass. Here's Marks. Pass Tisdale, lowers his shoulder. Tisdale limping. He's going to have to come out of the game. They haven't been able to stop the running back in the passing game.
These guys are so dangerous when they get the ball in space, and I love this from Marks. As soon as he catches it, he goes straight upfield, and really Tisdale there with the injury got way too far outside, which gave Marks that lane up the middle. You can tell he's battling an injury, and Marks as well comes off the field banged up.
Rodgers in another rhythm. He's completed his last 10 attempts. Earlier in this game, he had completed 15 straight in a run that spanned the second and third quarters. 12 different catches of the 31 completions by Mississippi State running backs. Here's another.
And you think about it, you went back to, I think you mentioned earlier, the time of possession. Right? Yeah. Mississippi State, I think, seventh in the entire country. It's because of the efficiency of Will Rogers, the ability to continually create positive plays through the air. Whether it's a 1 yard play or a 20 yard play, it doesn't matter. The clock continues to run, they control the ball, and they dictate the game.
And in this day and age of up-tempo offenses, high-scoring games, time of possession matters less per game than it did before.
Right.
10 years ago, 20 years ago, certainly 30 years ago. But not if you're Mississippi State and you have the lead. J.J. Jernigan listed first on the depth chart at running back, just got his first catch. Rodgers. Here's another one as well as that time out of the backfield.
And think about it. It allows you to continue to lean into your identity late in the fourth quarter. Right? I mean, this is where any other team would be running the football to try to take time off this clock. For Mississippi State, that's not what you do best. But because Will Rogers is so efficient, you can still throw the ball.
Yeah, because the ball doesn't hit the ground.
Exactly. You can still throw the ball and get the same effect, which is just it's special. Huge third down. This is the game right here. Kentucky has to get a stop down two scores.
First down. Jaden Wiley. And this run for Will Rogers. Let me tell you how impressive this is. Coming into this game, the Mississippi State school record for consecutive completions in a single game was 12. Rogers has beat that record twice tonight. Previous record, KJ Costello set that last year against Arkansas.
That's wild.
34 of 37.
And on that one right there, Kentucky brings pressure. Rogers sees it, replaces it with an easy throw. And you're just, if you're Brad White, you're just kicking yourself. There's nothing you can do. You have to get pressure on him. But when you do, he sees it. He completes another ball. It's extremely frustrating for this Kentucky defense.
Here's Marks. I think we learned something tonight about Mike Leach's play calling when it comes to turning to the ground game when they need it. 31 runs against 37 passes today. Coming in, the percentage was next to nil, last in the country in running. But he's willing to do it when he finds that window.
Is he? I think we're
tonight,
just learning it, right?
Yeah.
I mean, how many times have we asked him over the last couple of years, you know, will you run more? Will you lean into it if you need to? He goes, well, we're just going to do what we do. Well, I mean, maybe this is the game they needed to go, wait a minute, like, we could be a little more balanced. Still have the identity of the air raid, but we got a couple backs and an offensive line that's playing at a high level right now.
Screen. Bounce to the outside. Another State first down. That one goes for 11.
by Calvin.
Kentucky defense just gassed. You're seeing players have a lot of difficulty redirecting, not getting as many hats to the football as quickly as you were in the first half of this game.
Hands on hips everywhere. I mean, we're talking about the ball control. They use the perimeter throws so frequently. I mean, these D linemen and linebackers are trying to drop 8, 9, 10 yards deep in coverage. They're running 20, 30 yards sideline to sideline. I mean, it just wears you out.
14 consecutive completions now for Rodgers. Another run. 2 yards. Timeout taken by Kentucky. 2:24 remaining in regulation. Kentucky needs to catch a break.
Saturday's scene here in Starkville is always plenty wild enough. Then you throw in a great opponent at night on Halloween Eve, and we have no idea what we're going to get. But we absolutely know what we're not going to get.
I mean, I completely hate candy corn.
Candy corn.
Cole, Mike Leach was going to get some candy corn painted shoes from Adidas, wasn't he?
He wouldn't even put them on. I talked to the staff before the game, and Adidas did cut him some, I think it's some of the new Adi Zeros, and had him painted out candy corn, some other candies, and he wouldn't wear them. That's how much he hates candy corn. And by the way, I'm right there with him.
I don't mind it.
I'm not going to stand for the slander. There's nothing wrong with candy corn.
It's Thank gross. You.
Gross.
Here's Marks. Pick up a 5. He was nice enough to share instructions on how to eat candy corn. Open bag, pour candy corn into trash can, eat a peanut butter cup. Fine. Nothing says you can't have both.
Yeah. Why you gotta throw away good candy? Now this I can get on board with.
Yeah, Ted Lasso was all about the post-game interview talking about his candy. Solid gameplay, coach.
I'm all about the Sour Patch Kids. All over it.
Candy. Hashtag candy corn. Wait, who invited that guy? He has nothing. You don't have a letter on your chest, sir. You got a weird pattern of chest hair, too. 3rd and 4. 4-man rush. They go right past it with Marks. Pass square. Mississippi State first down. But I think we're going to look differently at Kentucky season. Now, this certainly impacts where they end up in the postseason, but I also look very differently upon Mississippi State and their promises for the rest of their season. 15 consecutive completions for Will Rogers. Timeout taken by Kentucky. Rogers has certainly grown into this role. Pretty impressive. I mean, really impressive. I don't know if there's a headless horseman to be found, but this was.
Hey, think fast.
Whoa.
Wow. That was actually pretty good.
Yeah.
Don't throw it that way.
That would be more incompletions than Will Rogers has had all night.
Unbelievable. Right? I mean, just think about how close this Mississippi State team is on the season. The close loss to Memphis, close one to LSU.
Hold on, I'm getting a note from off camera.
Is it a good one?
He's completed 30 of his last 31. Put that on a pumpkin. Put it in the middle of the set.
I think that's ideal. If you're a quarterback, completing 30 of 31 passes is ideal, especially if they look like this. It hasn't just been dink and dunk. He's pushed the ball to the perimeter, downfield more than we've seen in a few games. And I tell you what, if this offense is clicking like this and the defense is playing like we saw tonight, this Mississippi State team can compete with anybody.
Certainly. Still throwing pumpkins. One incompletion since the second possession of the first quarter for Rodgers. Going deep, looking for it all. Flag on the play. They put so much stress on this worn-out Kentucky defense.
Pass interference on the defense, number 29. 15-yard penalty from the previous spot. Automatic first down.
So we'll have Mississippi State
in Fayetteville next Saturday afternoon.
Correction, player number 14.
Rodgers trying to set the single game completion percentage record.
It's going to be helped out there that one hitting the ground was a pass interference.
I tell you who's watching this game tonight worried about what he's been able to do is Barry Odom.
Yeah.
Because what Barry Odom saw last year was KJ Costello,
yeah,
not what is now almost a veteran Will Rogers.
And also Bo Nix last week, very efficient and effective against an Arkansas defense.
Room on the edge. Flag on the play. Ball in the end zone again.
Holding on the offense, number 6.
They'll take this one back.
Due to the result of the play, the game clock will start on the snap.
And to that point, kind of spinning it forward, you know, Bo Nix in that game, I believe, off the top of my head, was 21 of 26. And Bo's not a guy that's normally efficient. If he can be that efficient against Arkansas, you got to think, unless a game plan changes and Barry Odom has a little different plan for this Mississippi State attack, Will Rogers can be very effective as well against that defense.
Is there a reason they're not just going victory formation?
Well, I mean, Kentucky, nope, there's not. I was just looking. I was like, well, nope, one timeout. No. Yeah, I don't know, Tom. You know, maybe Mike Leach thinks Kentucky is candy corn right now, and he's just trying to rub it in.
Marks swallowed up by Julia Bonnie Fitzgerald.
It really should be just taking a knee.
Maybe he doesn't want their rushing numbers to be negatively impacted.
I think he wants to pad the number of rushing attempts.
33 rushing attempts to 39 passes.
It's about as balanced as Mike Leach has been in some time. Kentucky will face a different animal when they get Tennessee and Josh Heupel's up-tempo offense next. They need to make sure one loss doesn't turn into two. But tonight it's been all maroon. Will Rogers will finish the game 36 of 39. 344 yards. One touchdown.
It's exactly what they needed out of their quarterback. The defense was opportunistic. Three interceptions, and Will Rogers was efficient and explosive at times, but I think the story for Mississippi State was still the run game. That was the game changer. 81 yards may not seem like a lot, but for Mississippi State, that is huge.
Mike Leach is talking candy with Cole.
Coach Leach, I don't know if you came in thinking that the rushing attack would be more of a trick, but it ended up being a treat for your offense tonight.
You know, not really a trick. Some of it you take what the defense gives us, and I know that these guys, I know that they're really good against the run, but we felt like that they were going to have to drop some people to cover the pass, and, you know, it was the type of thing where we were lucky enough to get them, I thought, a little off balance, and, you know, then run, pass, run, you know, kind of mixed it up. And the thing was some of the key plays, you know, just executing key plays is what allowed that to happen, not really a rushing play or a passing play. And converting third downs was really key to us today.
Coach, you mentioned that execution. At one point, Will Rogers, I believe, was 31 of 37 in this game. He didn't have an incompletion since the second possession of the first quarter. Why was he so efficient tonight?
I thought he had a lot of help. I thought, other than penalties, I thought we protected pretty good. And then the other thing, I thought the receivers bounced around and did their job, you know.
He's 36 and 39, and then, so I was actually wrong there.
Then I thought Woody played really well. Like at key situations, Woody Marks, I thought really did some good things.
Did you suggest that children maybe rethink their Halloween costumes and go as Will Rogers?
They can. I mean, who wouldn't want to be Will Rogers? You know, I think your kid had it right, but I think that, you know, Will Rogers wouldn't be, and that's kind of a Treasure Island sort of name, Will Rogers, so that would work out good.
Let's see if we can get him to gold. Thank you, Coach.
All right, Bubba.
Good job, Bubba. An SEC single game record with 30 attempts or more, breaking Josh Dobbs and Matt Corral's shared record that they each had against Vandy. And tonight, Will Rogers, 36 of 39. That's 92%. Bubba will be back with more, but for now, let's get you to SEC football final. Here's Dari.
Yeah, Tom, Jordan, Bub, we're going to send it back your guys' way here in just a little bit. Dari Doring-Chizik.